नावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं। समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैः स्तुष्टुवागंस्तनूभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः। स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्ताक्षो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्ददातु। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः। हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम। Yesterday, one of our satsangis, who is in this group but doesn't attend Mandukya, she says, I have a better taste. But she is in this group. She is around 50. Very, very well placed in life. Both children highly well placed. Husband is an international consultant. She is healthy and handsome and great devotee of Gurudev and takes classes regularly. You can't ask anything more. But that person, whenever we discuss, there's nothing in this world. With all this, he says, there's nothing in this world. Then I thought, okay, people like me can say that because too many challenges, too much of suffering, so you can say that there's nothing in this world. But a person who has not one challenge or one inadequacy saying that, why is so? Then suddenly Gurudev gave me all flashes of thoughts. Supposing you are a rich person, you have enough money, will you eat food with flies swarming next to a sewage canal? You won't, because you have the money to buy healthy, clean food. So you renounce that. Who renounces that? One who has better facilities and taste. So also houses. So also wives, sorry. Right? You go on renouncing things. But these renunciations are only relative. every renunciation of this in the material world makes you have another choice, which probably makes you more and more anxious and insecure. Even if not so, when you are 81, you will be thinking about maybe any time now. So, Ruddhastava Chinta Saktaha. So, this worry is there. And you can't eat. Half the things you can't eat. And the other half, what you like to eat, you won't get. And there are no people to serve you. Most of the people after 81, 82 need a help. And the very help needs another help. So this worry is there, starts from the age of 70, reminding you of the old age, possible clearing the way for others in the world. How can you be satisfied with such a compromise of life? An intelligent person would definitely like to find a way out of this and shake hands with Mr. Death and say, let's go. Old age, he doesn't care. Old age is for the body, not for me. No good food, I don't need. I'm full and complete inside. I'm enjoying with my Krishna, the butter, the fresh butter. It is this that we have to seek before it is too late. To seek this, you have to be rich. As I said, to renounce the cheap and unhygienic food, you have to be empowered with money. So to seek this, you have to be rich. Rich where? Rich in yourself, by yourself. It has to be only known and owned. It has to be known and owned. So, intelligent people try to seek this. And when they try to do this, the question, the various possibilities. And if there is a thing like that, which is absolute in its nature, undecaying, free from disease and death, complete and no inadequacy, no insecurity, no negative thoughts. If there is a thing like that, it has to be unchallenged. Unchallenged means it alone has to be there. Anything else limits it. Therefore, it has to be non-dual. But the world you and I transact is completely dualistic in its nature. In ourselves, the hand is not the leg. Both are not the head. Eyes are not the nose. Ears are not the tongue. Various differences in the body. Body is not the mind. Mind is not the intellect. And all of them are decaying, dying. And then, so many differences. Then outside world, of course, my friend, my enemy, my power, right? My servant, my boss, my wife, my children, my dog, very important. Right? So, this is the world that we live in, complete plurality. Inside you, within you, total plurality. The body, mind, intellect, again explained as the five koshas, annamaya, pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya, etc. Outside, jada, ajada, chaitanya, jiva, makshikaha, kita, animals, rakshasas. This is the outside world. So where and how you can say it's only one has to be there. That is where you need the Shastra, because what you can see, feel, think, do not need the Shastra. What you cannot see, feel, think, need the Shastra. Why? Because what you can see, feel, and think are finite. What you want is infinite. Infinite is beyond perceptions and feelings and thoughts. Hence, you have no means to know, and unless it is pointed out by somebody. Therefore, Sravana, by a loving, compassionate, enlightened, living guru. And then you contemplate in the direction in which he stays and discover, yeah, it is true. How was I so stupid not to know this, me? And I thought everything else is important. Now I know I don't need anything. So this is pointed out. And even when this is pointed out, still there is a duality. The self and not self. Therefore, it is said the not self is nothing but an expression of the self. The not self is an expression of the self. Why? Because you need transactions. And therefore, the same self remaining itself unchanged assumes different forms to serve you. Therefore, the Lord, remaining as the Lord, enters into a particular body, mind, intellect, maintains it, illumines it. Outside, he becomes the objects, emotions, and thoughts, and try to coordinate between them and give you an experience. And hence, it's all nothing but Advaita. Rhetoric nice, but experience is different. Hence, they have to give you various ways of analysis. What is a body? What is a mind? What is an intellect? What are the koshas? What is the nature of the external world? What is this self? How do you recognize the self in all? How do you recognize the self to be different from all? How do you recognize the self is all? They have to give you guidelines. And that is what Mandukya started for us, saying that in Omkara, the essence is silence. silence alone appears as Avumadi sounds. Silence in the beginning, silence in the middle, silence in between, silence at the end. Silence is Shabda Avuma. So also, the consciousness is the waker, dreamer, deep sleeper. And beyond the deep sleep. This analysis is very useful because without this discrimination of the waking dream and deep sleep, you cannot find a coordinating factor, a factor that witnesses the waking dream and deep sleep. Yet it doesn't change. For this purpose, the waking dream and deep sleep have to be analyzed. It also serves another this thing, how, in spite of the experience of the dualistic, pluralistic world, it's all the same truth by analysis of your dream and then trying to relate the dream and the waking are not different. Then it also shows to you how they are all one, homogeneous mass. And then from it, everything emerges. That is deep sleep. So two purposes mainly. One is nothing but that. Second is all of its expressions. Third is the expressions as different from that are illusions. The expressions as different from that truth, the dreamer as different from the waker, is an illusion. Hence, whatever is there is nothing but that. Rest is the mind. How does this mind work? Very interesting. COVID, when it came to 10,000, are you 10,000? You thought the world is coming to an end. It reached 90,000. Oh, you, then you were happy, slowly it came down, 16,000. And then you were relaxed, then suddenly 4 lakhs. And now yesterday it comes to 360. You are very happy. Earlier, 10,000 to 90,000, you were dreaded. Now 4 to 360, you are very happy. What is the truth of this world other than your mind? It alone makes something important, not important. Hence, detach from the mind and see the one who sees these various moods and starts feeling differently at different experiences. That is the purpose of Mandukya. And this, you may say, is it only Mandukya? Is it only a fanciful thought? Has it been said in Gita? Yes. 7th chapter, which Gurudev is going to take. Don't miss it. Bhumirapo nalo vayuhu kam mano buddhi revacha ahankaram itiyam me bhinna prakriti astada. My nature, my prakriti are the 5 elements. Bhumi, apa, Analaha, Vayuhu, Kam, Manaha, Buddhihi, Ahankaram, 8, 8-fold. These are the 8 wives of Sri Krishna. Astavasus. This world is my nature, lower nature. Is there something else? Yes. What is that? That is apareyam itah tu anyah. There is another thing other than this finite, vidhime param. That's my superior nature. Jeeva bhuta mahabahu yedam dharyate jagat. Having become the kshetrajna, the jeeva, it supports the entire world of names and forms. So I am the one supporting the names and forms. I am the name and names and the forms. The names and the forms are my lower nature. The supporting is my higher nature. Earring, chain and bangle is my lower nature. The gold that supports them is my higher nature. Earring, chain and bangle are not different from the gold. Gold alone is OET, PFT, ego and Omkara. And therefore, in the seventh chapter, he says, Vasudevaha Sarvamiti. You should be able to experience this entire world is nothing but Vasudeva. Matta parataram nasti. There's nothing other than me. All seven chapters. Matta parataram nasti. And thus, he makes us realize the oneness of the seen, the unseen, and that which is beyond the seen and the unseen. And then how do you experience that? Detach from the false. The higher will by itself reveal. Kyage naike amritatva manashu. You want immortality. You want infinite bliss. Renounce the lower ones. Renounce the eatables along the sewage canal. Choose the best. So renunciation is not negative. And therefore renunciation is glorified. Kyage naike namrutatva manush. Hence, renunciation, four types of renunciation. Kuti, chika, bahudaka, hamsa, paramahamsa. Hamsa and paramahamsa are called the highest because hamsa can discriminate between water and milk. The renunciates can discriminate between the false and the real. One king was going on a horse. A saint prostrated to him. The king got a shock and said, what are you doing, Swami? He said, no, we have renounced lower things for higher things. You are a great renunciate. You have renounced the higher for the lower. That is the glory of renunciation. And that again is said in Gita. Dukkha sam yoga viyogam yogam. What is yoga? Detaching from all that gives you sorrow. Dukkha sam yoga viyogam. What gives you sorrow? Everything experienced, including this class, gives you sorrow. And that is why some people said, today is the last day, don't go beyond this. Yeah, now let me try to go to the verses. It's a formality of closing the verses. I will be able to do probably up to 65, 70. There will be 20, 30. They are mostly repetitions to read by yourself. Anybody has any problem, which I do not think, because they are not going to read. If they read only problems, you can contact me. You see the beautiful way of analysis. If one reads these Upanishads and tries to understand the brilliance of their intellect, their approach to the subject, their analysis, he will become number one in whatever he does, including material life. You become not only sharp, but disciplined. And hence, now let us see a few verses. Na asti na satyad hetuhu na satyad hetuhu hetukam asat. Sorry, na asat hetukam asat. Na asat hetukam asat. Na asat hetukam asat. That means unreal is not the cause for the unreal. A son of barren women cannot produce another unreal son. Na asad hetukam asad. something which is not there cannot produce even a non-existing thing. Right? Sad asat hetukum tatha. Similarly, something which is there cannot produce a non-existing thing. Please remember two. Asat cannot produce asat. Sat cannot produce asat. And then satcha sad hetukam nasti. Something which is there cannot produce another thing which is of the same nature. A jar cannot produce another jar unless it is destroyed and modified. What is there cannot and need not produce something which will be there. Therefore, nasti sad hetukam asat krutaha. If something which is there cannot produce another thing, how can something which is there can produce which is not there? You understand? These are the four different possibilities of creation. The unreal cannot have the unreal as its cause. The horns of the hare cannot be the cause for the castle in the air. The real cannot be produced out of the unreal. We will have never the chance of attending the wedding of the barren woman's son. The real cannot be the cause of the real. Obvious, for a table cannot be the cause of another table. The real to be the cause of the unreal is an absurd impossibility. This is what Sri Gurudev says about these four possibilities. Viparyasad yatha jagrat achintyan bhutavat prushet tatha swapne viparyasat dharmaha tatraiva pashyati. Viparyasad yatha jagrat achintyan bhutavat prushet. Viparyan yatha jagrat achintyan bhutavat prushet tatha swapne viparyasat dharmaha tatraiva pashyati. They are very interesting way of putting. Usually you say the waking world is like a dream. The waking world is like a dream. That is the what up to now we have been said, right? Here he changes the order. Why? To make you think. Just as one in the waking state considers as real through false knowledge, like the mirage waters, the unreal objects whose nature cannot be described. You mirage waters, you cannot say it exists because you can't drink the water. You cannot say it doesn't exist because you are seeing it. Therefore, Maya is said to be asat, bhana matram, not real, but experienced. So you cannot say real or unreal. The very waking world objects. He is not saying dream objects and say waking is also like that. He says waking world itself is not real and cannot be described. Similarly, dream one also perceives through false knowledge objects whose existence is possible only in that condition. Just like under certain conditions, you see and experience the mirage waters, so also the dream world is experienced under such conditions. Both are not real.
Upalambhat samacharat asti vastutvadinam jatistu deshita buddhaihi ajate trastam sada.
But in the ritualistic portion of the Vedas and the various rituals, they, out of consideration for you, have said about God and the results,
because you are afraid of even imagining a state where you are Brahman, nothing else is there other than that. For those people, since they believe in what they see, what they transact, they see, they transact that they believe, a thing that which cannot be even thought of, like Brahman, they are scared. There was a girl coming to my class in Adyar. After a few classes, she didn't come. Somebody told me she started seeing ghosts after coming to my class. Right? So that is the fear of trying to see something which is beyond perceptions. So for their sake, the cause, the effect, karma, results have all been said even in the Vedas for those people. Ajate trastatam tesham upalambha dvyantihi jati dosha na seshyanti doshopi alpo bhavishyati. And these people who believe in what is seen, cause and effect, karma, phala, etc., they are out of their fear, do not admit ajati, the unborn Brahman. But you allow them like that, even Vedas allow, because the possibility of being hurt through that belief is negligible. There is no possibility at all, because he still believes some form of God, some concept of God, which is any day better than the egoistic world. And hence, there is not much of a danger. If it is there, also negligible. So the Shastras permit this duality in the ritualistic portions. Upalambhat samachara maya hasti yadhochyate. Upalambhat samachara asti vastu tathochyate. Yadha, just as, because you see, you try, you touch, you transact a maya elephant produced by a magician. So also, people believe in what they see, in what they can transact. Just like one believes a Maya elephant, because he sees it, he transacts with that. This world of names and forms also, people believe because they are perceived and they can transact. Jatyabhasam, chalabhasam, vastvabhasam, tathayvacha. Aja, achala, achalam, avastutvam, vijnanam, jnana, vijnatam, shantam advayam. All that you see as varieties, which seems to be born, which seems to be moving, and which seems to be the objects, all of them are nothing but aja, unborn, achala, motionless, avastu, not a substance, vijnanam, that consciousness, jnanam, advayam. All this pluralistic world is nothing but that advaya jnanam. And now he gives you an example for you. He gives an example for you. Excuse me. I'll just take a half a minute to. Yeah.
need an example. Always, any theory is established on three counts. A time-tested statement, which is called Shruti, Yukti, logic, Anubhava, experience. So you need an example which can satisfy these three conditions, Shruti, Yukti, Anubhava. He is giving a beautiful example here. Ruju, Vaktradi, Vaktradik, Abhasa. Abhasam alatam alatas panditam yatha grahana grahaka abhasam vijnanas panditam tada grahana grahaka abhas. The duality of the object and the subject, the duality of the perceiver and the perceived, grahana grahaka, object and the subject. This duality is exactly as the firebrand when it's rotated as you want the forms, it brings out various motions, straight, ruju, vakra, crooked. You know, when you move a firebrand or a udubati, you can bring a circle, you can make a square, you can make a eight in that, you can you turn it, it looks like an eight, it right, you can make an oval, you can make whatever form you want with one tip of that firebrand. Why? How? The firebrand in motion brings in those forms. Similarly, the consciousness through its own nature of sentiency brings out these forms. Aspandamanam alatam anabhasam ajam yatha. Aspandamanam vijnanam anabhasam ajam yatha. When the firebrand is not in motion, aspandamanam ajam, there is no creation. So also, when this vijnanam, this consciousness is aspandamanam, not in motion, everything is ajam, unborn, changeless. Alate spandamane vai na abhasa anyato bhuvaha na tataha anyatra nispandan na alatam pravishantite. When this firebrand is rotated, the various forms have not come from elsewhere. When this firebrand stops in its motion, all the forms does not merge into it from somewhere else. So there is no real entering into the firebrand. There is no generation of forms from the firebrand. It's all a trick of the motion of the firebrand. Similarly, trick of this consciousness in motion is the various world of names and forms. Na nirgata alata te dravya dravyatvabhava yogataha abhava yogataha vijnane pi tathaiva sihu abhasasya avisheshataha. The appearances of the different shapes do not emerge from the firebrand because they are not substantial things. The various forms are not substantial. Therefore, there is no real emergence. It also appears is the same for the consciousness. There are no objects other than the consciousness. Vijnane spandamane vai na abhasa anyato bhuvaha nata anyatra nispandana vijnanam vishantite. The same thing has been repeated. The forms have not come somewhere. The forms don't go into that. Na nirgate aste vijnana dravyatva bhava yogataha karyakaranata abhava
yato achintya tad sadaivate. The appearances do not emerge from the consciousness. They are not real entities. Dravya abhava. These are always beyond comprehension. You cannot say they are there or not there because you are seeing. But on verification, they are not there. Therefore, you cannot define them. So is this world. You cannot define it as real or unreal. Dravyam dravyasya hetuhu. Material can be cause for another material. Dravyam dravyasya hetuhu syat anyasya chaivahi, which is not a substance, an imagination or a mental thought can bring another emotion. One emotion can bring another emotion, which is not a substance, but an emotion can bring another emotion. Like Gurudev says, you show your love to somebody, that person tries to show you love. So one emotion generates another emotion. That's not a substance. Dravyatvam anyabhavova dharmanam na upapadyate. Dravyatvam anyabhavova dharmanam na upapadyate. Dharmanam of the egos. Dravyatvam. The character of being a substance, anyabhavaha, nor being a non-substance, upapadyate, doesn't arise at all of the dharmas, dharmanam, the egos. Evam na chitta dharmaha, chittam vapina dharmajam, evam hetu phala jatim, pravishanti manishanaha. Similarly, the egos have not been evam chittaja dharmaha. Similarly, objects have not come from the mind, nor the mind from the objects. Yeah, this is a very interesting thing that is talked in Bhagavata. The question was, consciousness plus object is mind. Consciousness plus object is mind. And what is an object? Something which the mind recognizes. Mind is formed by the object. Object is formed by the mind. So which now is the cause, which is the effect? Both are interdependent on each other. Both are interdependent on each other. If that being the case, how do you explain the world or the mind? Because there is no mind without the objects. There are no objects without the mind. Because when you sleep, the mind is not there. You don't experience the objects. Both are interdependent. So out of something interdependent, there cannot be anything which is concrete. Beautifully, he deals with this subject in Bhagavata. He says that is because both of them are me. The mind is also me. The objects are also me. Try to go to the root of the mind and the objects. You will discover me. Yavad hetu phala veshaha. Tavad hetu phalodbhava. Kshine hetu phala veshaha. Nasti hetu phalodbhava. As long as you are in this causation hunting, that long this will bother you, and it's real in the transactional world. As long as your mind goes on asking why, right? Causes. Then you find the law of causation works. When you go beyond it, the law of causation ceases for you. Gurudev here brings out something interesting. He says, so is the various things, the world. You know, women's,
If somebody believes in womans and Rahu Kalam, it works for them. If you don't believe, it doesn't work for you. The womans are not standard. Same for all and same throughout the universe. This Rahu Kalam is very interesting. It's only in the south. Now even the other religion people are following Rahu Kalam. But if you believe and you do not follow, you will definitely find something wrong. If you don't believe, it doesn't upset you because the whole problem is your mind.
Yavad hetu phalaveshah samsara tavad ayatah chine hetu phalaveshi samsaram na prapadyate.
As long as you are seeing the cause and effect, this samsara is there. When you stop seeing the cause and effect, there is no samsara. Samsara means that which continuously changes. You are seeing the waker to be the cause of the dreamer. So as long as you believe in that, you see the dream. And when you know there is no waker, there is no dreamer, it's all me, the consciousness, there is neither the waker nor the dreamer, there is no samsara at all.
Samritya jayate sarvam shashvatam nastitena vai sadbhavena hi ajam sarvam uchchedastena nasti vai samrita. Through illusion all this happens. There is no permanence in them,
and being real, there is no destruction also. See, since they are all by nature illusion, there is no production. Because it is truth, there is no destruction. That is, you know, the creation and destruction, the job of Brahma and Shiva. He says nothing is there. Why? Because you are Brahma, you are Shiva.
Dharma cha iti jayante jayante te na tattvatah janma mayo pamam tesham sa cha maya na vidya. Those entities can constituting the separate ego center are said to be born.
Egos, which is mere illusory feeling, are said to be born through Maya. But the Maya itself is not there. Very confusing, you know. How is your dream born? Can you explain what power brings the dream? You do not know. The power is not anywhere else other than in you. You have the power in you to bring a non-real dream to be as though real. That power in you to make that which is impossible possible is called Maya. And what is it? It is not there at all. There is nothing like that. It's just an illusion. There is nothing as Maya also. Only to explain to you how this happens, why this happens, you have to bring the word Maya. But when you, in your experience, find that there is neither a waker nor a dreamer, the Maya itself is not there.
Yatha Maya Maya Bija Jayate Tan Yo Ankuraha Nasau Nityo Nacha Uchedi Tadvat Dharmeshu Yojana.
The magician shows you a seed. Then he keeps there and puts a basket on that. Then he lifts the basket. You see a sprout. Then again he puts there. You see a plant. Then again he removes and then puts the basket. You see a mango coming from that. And he takes the mango, cuts and distributes also. You eat it also. All this is Maya. How is it possible? Something you experience and you say Maya. This happened in London. P.C. Sarkar, one of our great magicians, was giving a show in London. He went half an hour late. The Britishers, known for their discipline, were all fuming. He said, what is the problem? They said, you are late by half an hour. He said, look at your watches. All watchers showed the right time. They couldn't believe. Then they went to Big Ben. Big Ben also showed the same time. So it is possible to make false things appear as real, even through Maya. It's called hypnotism. Na ajeshu sarvadharmeshu shashvata ashashvata bhida yatra varnana vartamte viveka tatra namuchyate. You cannot say these are permanent, not permanent. Why you cannot say? Because you cannot say impermanent, because in essence it is real. You cannot say the gold chain, earring, bangle are impermanent because it's nothing but gold. You cannot say the earring, chain, and bangle are eternal because they are destroyed. So what you see, if you see the vastu, they are real. If you see the name and form, they are not real. And therefore, that which you cannot say, which is real or unreal, how can you say, which is, how can you discriminate on such things? Yatha svapne dvayabhasam chittam chalati mayaya tatha jagrat dvayabhasam chittam chalati maya. Just as you experience duality in your dream through maya, the waking is also an experience of the maya. Advayam cha dvayabhasam chittam svapnena samshayah advayam cha dvayabhasam tatha jagranna samshayah. The advayam, the non-dual truth in dream and waking alone manifests out of it the pluralistic world. Swapna druk pracharan swapne dikchuvai dasha susthitan andajan svedajan vapi jivan pashyati yan sada. In the dream, going in multi-various directions, you see the multi-various species like andajan, born out of egg, Svedajan, born out of water or sweat and all that. Various things you see in your dream, going checkers. So also in the waking world, going checkers through your mind, seeing things through your mind, you experience this world of plurality. Swapna druk chitta drushyasti na vidyamte tata prutak tata tadrushyame vedam swapna druk chittamishyati. Just as the dream world is not different from the dream mind, which is not different from the consciousness, so is the waking world is not different from the waker's mind, which is again the same consciousness. Charan jagarate jagrat dichuvai dashasu titan andajan svedajan vapi jivan pashyati yan sada. In the waking also, going in different directions, you see different species. Jagrat chitte chitta ikshanayaste na vidyamte tatapudak tada tadrushyame vedam jagat chitta ishyate. The whole world is nothing but the mind, is not separate from the perceiver. The very perceiver is the consciousness, which is the mind. Ubehi ube anyonya drushye 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 tekim tadastiti na uchyate lakshana shunyam ubhayam tan tanmate naiva brukyate. The ego and the mind are objects of perception of each other. Without the mind, you cannot even see, feel the ego. Without the ego, you cannot see the mind. And that being the case, which is independent of the other, both are devoid of the marks by which they could be distinguished. They don't have specific traits through which you can say this is this, this is that. And therefore, they're all cognized only through the other. It's just an illusion. Yatha svapnamayo jivo jayate mrete picha tatha jiva ami sarve bhavanti cha bhavanti cha. Just as in the way the dreamer is born, dreamer lives for some time, dreamer dies, the waking also is manifest for some time, remains for some time, and then merges back for some time. Yatha maya mayo jivo jayate mrete picha tatha jivo ami sarve bhavanti cha bhavanti cha. And then you have the waking ego, the dream ego,
then you have something other than that. Yatha nirmitiko jivu, constructed ego. I am this, I am that. Jayate mrite piva, tatha jivu ami sarve bhavanti na bhavanti. All these are appear and disappear. They are all nothing but tricks of the consciousness and the mind. Nakkarchi jayate jivaha. Sambhavosya na vidyate. Yetad uttamam satyam. Yatra kinchinna jayate. This is the conclusion. Nakkinchi jayate jivaha. Nakkarchi jayate. The jiva, the individual, is not born out of something. Sambhavo asya na vidyate. And there is no cause for this jiva. Yetad uttamam satyam. Yatra kinchit na jayate. This is the highest truth, that nothing is ever born. There is no jiva. There is no cause for this jiva. And hence, there is no creation. Throughout this, what he has done is demolishing the very loss of causation. Because once you accept cause-effect relationship, you have to accept creation. He says the very cause-effect relationship is total illusion. And hence, there is no creation other than your own mind. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Narayana. Thank you all. God bless you.